everyone. Today I'm going to do a bottle cap pour again. The last one that I did, the big yellow flower, was on a Tylenol lid like this. I found another lid from not a Tylenol bottle, but a no-name brand acetaminophen bottle. So I'm borrowing it for a bit. I'm going to try it. Just on a small, this is 6x6. Just a little canvas. So I'm going to put some white around. And we'll see how it turns out. I got some red, purple. I got some Winsor Newton. Violet. That I've mixed with pouring medium and floetrol. I've got some Dollar Rowney red, real bright red. I've got some gold, Artist Loft gold, mixed with floetrol and floetrol. I have some white, and I've put in some metallic white in with my white just to give it a little different color. So I'll pour the white first. See how this goes. All right, you have to go slow with this so that it doesn't go over that part. Just let it go down the slits. So do some red. These are mostly transparent colors, except for the white, of course. I think I'll put some gold in between. Now I'll do some purple. just being gentle. The purple doesn't seem to be a smooth edge there on that's going under the gold. Maybe the gold's heavier. I'll put some white now. Well, I see my red disappeared. We'll see what we get at the end. Put my red now. Well, I'm not liking my color choices so far here. I have an idea. I'm just gonna do a spiral on the top now. I don't like that gold in there. I'll see how it goes when I mix it in here. I'll add a little bit more. Need more purple. I think I will do a spiral pour on another one. It looks kind of cool. Look at those colors. Aren't they pretty? I'm going to have to take this lid out. So if I take this out, I might want to pour some more paint in the middle. So I'll get some ready. Oops, lots of purple in there. Okay, I'm just gonna lift this up. Oh, it's sectioned in there. Try this hand. Maybe it'll run in. I'll just go around slowly. Let's come down to this corner a little bit. Wow. Well, that looks kind of cool. Alrighty. I wish this was more rounded. I didn't have any silicone in this. But there's some cells. Can't see the white much. Anyway, I think it's pretty. I'll hold it up. I bet you can have a look. So it started out to be a bottle cap pour and turned into a spiral pour. Thanks for watching. Come back soon to Carol's Art Room. I'll put the dried result at the end. And I'm going to give this bottle cap another try. All right.
Bye-bye.
All right, I came back with this one. And I don't really care for it, so I'm trying to decide what to do with it. If I should just make some lines, or should I do a balloon smash? Well, what I could do is do the lines. Should I go in, or should I go out? Go in, that way it'll make a nice design there. Oh, I meant to do it on the other side. Oh, it's okay. This might make it look prettier. Now what? That's kind of cool. Does that look better? I do. I really think it looks better. I think I'll just leave it. Probably could do another one here. There, I think it's better now. Awesome. Right there, I just made it look a lot better. Christina usually goes in. Sometimes I go out. Sometimes I go in, but it made the center prettier by going in. All right. I think there's enough room for one more right here. All right, I'm done. I'll show you a close up. Much better. All right, have a great day, bye-bye. Hi everyone. Here is my dried bottle cap pour spiral. Well, I turned it into a spiral anyway. I think it looks really awesome. I love how the gold came out nice here. Some purple here. I think this was supposed to be purple too, but it went in with the red, so it's dark. Because it didn't put any black in there. Anyway, I like it. I'll try it again sometime. I'll give you a close up.
the center's cool too. So I did the lines to make it look more flowery. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.